In the name of the Lord of Initiation. Amen. I fly and I alight as an hawk of Mother of Emerald on my mighty sweeping wings. I swoop down upon the black earth and it gladdens into green at my coming. Children of Earth, rejoice! Rejoice exceedingly, for your salvation is at hand. The end of sorrow is come. I will ravish you away into mine unutterable joy. I will kiss you and bring you to the bridal. I will spread a feast before you in the house of happiness. I am not come to rebuke you or to enslave you. I bid you not turn from your voluptuous ways, from your idleness, from your follies. But I bring you joy to your pleasure, peace to your languor, wisdom to your folly. All that ye do is right, if so be that ye enjoy it. I am come against sorrow, against weariness, against them that seek to enslave you. I pour you lustral wine that giveth you delight both at the sunset and the dawn. Come with me, and I will give you all that is desirable upon earth. Because I give you that of which earth and its joys are but shadows. They flee away, but my joy abideth even unto the end. I have hidden myself beneath a mask. I am a black and terrible god. With courage conquering fear shall ye approach me. Ye shall lay down your heads upon mine altar, expecting the sweep of a sword. But the first kiss of love shall be radiance on your lips, and all my darkness and terror shall turn into light and joy. Only those who fear shall fail. Those who have bent their backs to the yoke of slavery until they can no longer stand upright, them will I despise. But you who have defied the law, you who have conquered by subtlety or force, you will I take unto me. Even I will take you unto me. I ask you to sacrifice nothing at mine altar. I am the God who giveth all. Light, life, love, force, fantasy, fire. These do I bring you. Mine hands are full of these. There is joy in the setting out. There is joy in the journey. There is joy in the goal. Only if ye are sorrowful, or weary, or angry, or discomforted, then ye may know that ye have lost the golden thread, the thread wherewith I guide you to the heart of the grooves of Eleusis. My disciples are proud and beautiful, they are strong and swift, they rule their way like mighty conquerors. The weak, the timid, the imperfect, the cowardly, the poor, the tearful, these are mine enemies, and I am come to destroy them. This is also compassion, an end to the sickness of earth, a rooting out of the weeds, a watering of the flowers. Oh, my children, ye are more beautiful than the flowers. Ye must not fade in your season. I love you. I would sprinkle you with the divine dew of immortality. This immortality is no vain hope beyond the grave. I offer you the certain consciousness of bliss. I offer it at once on earth. Before an hour has struck upon the bell, ye shall be with me in the abodes that are beyond decay. Also, I give you power earthly and joy earthly, wealth and health and length of days. Adoration and love shall cling to your feet and twine around your heart. Only your mouth shall drink of a delicious wine, the wine of Iacchus. They shall reach ever to the heavenly kiss of the beautiful God. I reveal unto you a great mystery. Ye stand between the abyss of height and the abyss of depth. And either awaits you a companion, and that companion is yourself. Ye can have no other companion. Many have arisen, being wise. They have said, seek out the glittering image in the place ever golden, and unite yourselves with it. Many have arisen, being foolish. They have said, stoop down unto the darkly splendid world, and be wedded to that blind creature of the slime. I, who am beyond wisdom and folly, arise and say unto you, achieve both weddings, unite yourselves with both. Beware, beware, I say, lest ye seek after the one and lose the other. My adepts stand upright, their head above the heavens, their feet below the hells. But since one is naturally attracted to the angel, another to the demon, let the first strengthen the lower link, the last attach more firmly to the higher. Thus shall equilibrium become perfect. I will aid my disciples. As fast as they acquire this balanced power and joy, so faster will I push them. They shall in their turn speak from this invisible throne. Their words shall illumine the worlds. They shall be masters of majesty and might. They shall be beautiful and joyous. They shall be clothed with victory and splendor. They shall stand upon the firm foundation. The kingdom shall be theirs. Yea, the kingdom shall be theirs. In the name of the Lord of Initiation.
Amen.